the approach by the church been? I mean, for me, what I've seen is it's more or less about the fear of the church than the love of the church for the youth. We've been told by our parents, you got to behave this way, you have to do it this way. If not, you know, the father will be upset with you, or the bishop will be upset with you. You have to be a Christ-like person, and this Christ-like person, and pretty much what you have to do is weighing heavy on them, because that is an added pressure with all the pressure that they have with school, what they're going on, with, you know, new relationships they are getting into, all that. This is another, like, you can't be true to yourself is one of the problems, because apparently the image the church has created is as such that if you behave the way you want to behave, you are, oh, you're a bad person. You're not good. You know, how can you do this? You're a shame to the family. That kind of attitude. And that I have seen, Bishop, especially the youth, is slowly detaching themselves from the church and saying, okay, maybe this is not my place. But then again, how can you all invite them back and understand and talk to them and try to get, you know, it is not about somebody up here and you are down here, but it is equally trying to have, like, for me to have a conversation with you at your higher stature and for me on my lower, but still we are able to exchange ideas and try to understand what's going on from your end and what's going on from my end. How can we replicate that in most of our churches these days?
One of the important things is to keep the conversation going and never get tired of it, because the youth need to be heard, and their place in the church must be secured. If there is a situation where the church is stubborn, the church is refusing to give ear to the youth must not give up. But they must make their voices felt in the church, because the church is them. Yes. It's not. They are the future of the church. They are the church. We always get completely distracted with the fact that, oh, they are the future. And so we get on with what's the problems of today. But the real thing is that the youth are the church of today. And we need to take them seriously. And if we don't, then we have missed. The church itself has missed its vocation in the world, and not just the church youth who are in the church, but we also have to relate to the youth who are outside there, because they want meaning to life. They want meaning to life, and I think if the church can relate to all youth, irrespective of whether they are Christian or not, then they will see in the church a hope for their lives. So they don't have to join the church, but they must see that there is a community that respects them, takes them seriously, their hopes, their aspirations, their dreams, and so that they can draw something for themselves, meaning, values, and use it to better themselves.